the folks you meet in our town. The folks you meet on any street in our town. Pick out any cottage, white or brown, they're all so appealing with that lived-in feeling.
The whole story speaks of something simple yet complex called love. Sun, moon, stars, waking up, sleeping, every simple fact about life that we need to love, but usually we don't appreciate that.
When you first read the play Our Town, you just see it as this beautiful little play, like there's nothing complicated or nothing over the top, it's just this very pretty little play. But the more you work with it, the more you read it, you fall in love with it, and you realize there's just so much to learn from it, there's just so much of value in it.
If you make it your town to.
The play uses very subtle music. It doesn't distract, or how should I say it, take the audience's attention away from what's actually happening on stage. It makes sure that it adds that small bit of flavor that helps the audience to connect to the characters, and also it helps the actors to connect to the characters that they're portraying. So I think the music plays an important role.
You in this our 2x4 town, welcome on the door of town.
Everybody knows in their bones that something is eternal, and that something has to do with human beings. I play the stage manager, who acts as the narrator and takes the audience on a journey through Grover's Corners and the lives of the people living in Grover's Corners. The stage manager is a very unique character that manipulates the time. For an example, he starts the play by introducing one character, and 5 seconds later he says that he died. Both of these ladies have cooked 3 meals a day. One for 20, the other for 40. They've brought up 2 children apiece, washed, cleaned the house, and never a nervous breakdown.
I play Mrs. Webb in the drama Our Town, which is set in Grover's Corners, New Hampshire. And the two main families throughout the drama are the Gibbs family and the Webb family. I'm part of the Webb family, and these two families highlight consistency in everyday life. You see Mrs. Gibbs and Mrs. Webb waking up, cooking, cleaning, sending their children to school, the milkman coming in, delivering the milk, conversation, and it seems very pretty, just, you know, just everyday life, and it seems very simple. Two mirror images, two households, and it's a new take also because there are no props. So it's all imaginary, you see imaginary cup, imaginary newspapers. But what you really realize throughout this play is that there's more to life than what you just see on the surface. It's more complex, it's complicated, and it's intricate. And that is what Our Town will bring to you. It will show you how much more everyday life means to you, and how much you do not appreciate it while you're living.
You can't have none, you can't have one without the other.
Wilde actually writes to one of his friends in 1937, he says, I'm writing the most beautiful little play with all the big subjects in it, and it's a big play with all the little things in life lovingly pressed into it. And I found that really meaningful, because I think that's exactly what the play is about, and there's no person who would have understood it better than Wilde himself.
Try to separate them, it's an illusion. Try a new
world. I play Emily Webb. At the start of the play, she's 16 years old. She is just an average 16-year-old girl. Nothing extraordinary. Carriage
Dad was told by mother, you can't have one.
You can't have none.
You can't have one without the other.
George is a 16-year-old high school kid, lives next door to Emily, practically grew up together. He's really good in sports and very popular in the town. George and Emily don't fall in love just like that. It's based on an understanding and communication. As in realizing that they care about each other enough. Thornton Wilder shows love in an interesting way. He shows that we do fall in love. We enjoy the music, we enjoy life. But most of the time, we don't appreciate the small things in life. For example, the breakfast we had in the morning. Do we appreciate the moments that we have there with our parents, with our loved ones, with our kids, husbands, wives? Or do we let those moments pass us by? Because we never know whether we will ever get those moments again.
A world that's warm and kind.
And George, it's a fact.
Is
go
more
on,
than just
a
passing token.
George attempts to ask Emily on a date, but it goes horribly wrong because she's angry.
Emily's angry with George for not taking notice of the things and people around him.
And he tries to give excuses. For example, blame it on the characteristics of an average male, things like that. But it doesn't work out.
Because Emily doesn't bite.
Yeah.
But he sees an opportunity where he turns it around, saying that men aren't perfect, but women are.
Because then, Emily actually says men are perfect.
Yeah. Yes. And then George turns it around. And then
Emily breaks down.
Yeah.
Because she realizes what she was just saying and doing, so she breaks down. And George
sees that opportunity and takes it.
Yes. This play went on to win the Pulitzer Prize in 1938. And here we are 77 years later, Q Theatre performing this play in Sri Lanka. And it isn't the first time that this play has been performed in Sri Lanka, because in 1990, this was performed in Sinhalese in Sri Lanka. And it has also been converted into, translated into over 30 languages, performed worldwide. And this is regarded as one of the only plays that is running every single day in some part of the world. So follow us on our Facebook page and you will get all the details about our event, which is coming up shortly. And I hope you will be there to see Q Theatre's take on Our Town. And we hope that you will like it, and that you would enjoy it, and you're bound to enjoy it.